assemblies and classes and those kinds of things. It's an extraordinary student body that's led by an extraordinary faculty. And I am grateful for you all each day that we have a chance to be together. I do want to say just one more time that standing where I am looking at this array of musicians is really pretty stunning. And it's hard for me to resist calling out a round of applause for all of you all, the music that you're on.
Thank you. of the coming of the Messiah. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of shadow and death, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
This is a reading from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that the census should be taken of the entire Roman world, and everyone went to his hometown and registered. But Joseph went to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be Mary's maid, but was expecting a baby. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and Mary gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
Thank you.
This is a reading from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2. At that time, there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven.
Gloria a Dios en las alturas.
Eres a God in heaven.
그와 같이 높이 오디슈.
지극히 높은 곳에서는 하나님께 영광이요.
荣耀属于至高无上神.
Gloria a Dio nell'altri cieli.
In la fonte del Hosemo.
Gloria in altissimo Deo.
And on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests.
Y en la tierra paz, buena voluntad para con los hombres.
Und Frieden auf Erden, Menschen ein Wohlgefallen.
Im Besten und Sonnenkiel Erden.
땅에서 하나님이 기뻐하신 사람들 중에 평화로다.
愿神所眷顾的人们平安.
E pace in terra a uomini di buona volontà.
And prego, Padre, for all of men to be highly fed.
Et super terram pax in hominibus bonae voluntatis.
When the angels have left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph, and the baby who was lying in the manger.
Thank you. is a reading from the first chapter of the Gospel of John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. The Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. All things came into being through him. Without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and that life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. The Word became flesh and lived among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. From his fullness we have all received grace upon grace.
Amen. family, friends who may not know me. I'm Leslie Ann Little, and I have the privilege of being the head of middle school. And on today, like today, it is indeed a privilege. And first, I want to thank all of you who brought us this amazing service. This includes our readers, our musicians, the ushers, and all of the adult coordinators that make this happen. So thank you all. Remember that the hard work you put in each day since August is your best preparation. So stick to your schedule. Remember not just to review, but to rework. Take breaks to refresh, and you will do well. And that goes for you students as well. Truly, may this be a time filled with blessings and joy for all of us. It is a time that we come together and appreciate the diverse talents, the diverse humans that make up our amazing community, and all of the splendor and traditions that are a part of this season, and a happy Hanukkah, which starts tomorrow. So may the Christmas message of peace on earth, goodwill to all of humankind, be a reminder of the importance of unity and understanding. May we celebrate the God of all people, each in our individual way, and together in harmony. So Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays to you. May you find joy in unexpected ways, and may you find ways to share that joy with others. So I want to wish you all a very Merry Christmas. And I also want to dismiss first, our eighth grade, you are headed to seventh period.